742, is that your song? You like that song, Garrison?
Yeah, it's a old 80s song. You know?
Yeah, it's your word for the day, our gift to you. Garrison, yes. Dude, joining us right here on the BT Couch, employment coach and director of employment over at Abbotsford Community Services. We are talking about the summer season, getting the youth ready, getting the parents ready. And what do you find are the most popular jobs, summer jobs, for the youth out there right now?
Well, the most accessible, you know, BC being a service-based economy, retail jobs are usually readily available, restaurant jobs, you know, getting out there and making tips and that sort of thing. Also, landscaping, those jobs are popular, and you can pick up some construction jobs as well. So all of those are good sources for people that are looking.
Well, we both know you get a job at an early age, you learn the importance, the value of a dollar. But yes. One of the important things you have as a coach is having a plan, getting a specific goal of which way you want to go with the job.
You need to have a plan. Very often when I work with young people, I ask them, what do you want to do? What kind of job you're looking for? And they all say customer service, and that's so broad. So I usually say, well, customer service, working for a garbage company as customer service, and it gets them thinking, well, no, not that. Customer service, working for a cell phone company or something like that. They get more specific. So what you want to do is get the young people to try and focus on being more specific than just a broad statement like customer service or a broad field or something like that. You want them to narrow down their choices. So just get them thinking a bit with a little brainstorming.
So say we find our industry, and let's throw a hypothetical example out there. We're going to work retail. Yep. What are the best resources out there to say, okay, what's available on the retail side for the summer
months?
Well,
Nordstrom's right now, they're going to hire over 1,000 people, so that's a great opportunity. Retail teaches you fantastic skills, and people may be surprised that I mentioned retail, but think about it. Communication skills, how do you get along with others, the pressure of meeting your sales quota, that's really important to work under pressure, real world skills that you're learning, soft skills that are so valuable in North America. We put a lot of emphasis on presentation here in North America. It's used as a way to advance in your career. So learning those skills early, handling cash, sometimes some people are elevated to a supervisor position, they learn how to budget a little bit and look to make their floats that they get for their cash floats to make sure they balance. So there's all sorts of great skills you learn in retail that you can transfer to many different careers.
Good critical skills right there. And for the job listings, what are the best resources out there to find the opening, aside from Nordstrom's, which is a great example?
Well, there's lots of websites out there, Workopolis, and even the WorkBC site. Our program is part of the WorkBC projects here in the province. You go on that website, WorkBC, just Google that. It's got job search information. It's got job postings. It's a really good, valuable resource.
Timing, also so key. We're sitting here at the beginning of June. School's going to wrap up. We got to get those jobs quick. You're saying start early.
Start early. It's almost too late now. I would start my job search late April, early May. And that's where all of the valuable jobs are available. You know, these jobs run up really quickly. Also, when we talk about resources and what the province and federal government have to offer, they have a lot of programs to assist those summer students going into the workforce. There's a lot of employer incentive programs that the government uses to get youth employed. So those opportunities usually go quickly. So you want to start looking early.
And, you know, for coaching, for those that didn't get that application in early, but now there's that sense of urgency to get that job now, what do you say is the number one thing in a job interview for an applicant to ace the interview and stand out among the rest?
Well, you want to be confident, and most people get nervous, but stick with what you know about yourself, which gets into planning again. You know, it's good to beforehand know your skills, know your strengths. A good question I ask people, it's not what they think their strengths are. What do others think your strengths are? And that usually elicits a more of an honest answer. And start to ask people, like, what are you good at? If you notice that you're good at making people laugh, obviously the communication skills are there. If you're good at organizing, you have organization skills. If you're always fixing things and rearranging things for people. So keep an eye on that. And I also personally keep a checklist of things that bring me a lot of joy in my everyday life that are work-related. And I mark that down. So if I help somebody with a resume and I really enjoyed that experience, I keep that in my mind and say, well, I like that type of work and I like doing those types of things.
Good to share those interests. These are great tips. Garrison, great to meet you.
Pleasure.
Thanks for sharing the wisdom, and hopefully you out there can benefit and get a job by summer season. I know we're a little late on it already, but hopefully it works out for you.
There's still some jobs out there.
Over the next few months.